my past 25 years of networking experience, I've had the opportunity to train literally thousands of individuals in various disciplines. Back in the old days, it was Novell, and then Microsoft, and now Cisco, and that's where I've been for the last 10 years. But I've recognized a common thread in individuals who are successful, not only in certifications, but also successful in their careers in networking. And I wanted to pass those tips on to you as far as what you can do to be successful in passing your exams and making sure that you really get and understand the technology. There's five basic steps. The first one is that Rome is not built in a day. And a Cisco certification is not obtained in a day. So the first step is to schedule time for study. Whether it's 2 hours a night, 3 days a week, or 1 hour a night, 5 days a week, or whatever it is, make sure that everybody in your life understands that that time is dedicated to study, that you can avoid interruptions if possible, and make sure you really allocate your time. I know, I get it. When I was in 2001, when I was getting my first CCIA and route switch, I allocated about 4 hours a day, 4 or 5 days a week, and I had four young children, and it wasn't easy, but you know what? It was worth it. So set yourself up for success. Allocate enough time for studies. Okay, the second pillar in our five steps of success. The problem is when you're studying, don't do Facebook. Don't do MySpace. Don't do email. Don't waste away your time in frivolous activities that are taking away from your study time. And while you're studying, what are you going to study? Well, that's a key point. I'd like to direct you to Cisco's website as you focus on what you should be studying. This is the detailed exam topics from Cisco on their website about what they expect a CCNA to know. So I would take each one of these topics one by one, maybe extract them, copy paste it into an Excel spreadsheet or a notepad, whatever, and then I would rate yourself on each of these items. What do you mean, Keith? Rate myself. Check it out. You're going to rate yourself 1, 2, or 3 on each topic. A 1 means I don't have any really good idea of exactly how that works. And 3 would be I totally understand it. I could demonstrate it. I could explain it. And 2 is somewhere in the middle. Why? Because you're going to take this blueprint, if you will, the exam topics, and rate yourself from 1 to 3, and you're going to study individual topics until you are at a level 3 on each one. So again, it's not done in a day. I would simply rate myself on everything. And then I would start with something that looks interesting to me, like, okay, here, the OSI reference model, great. If I'm at a level 1, and I didn't even know there were 7 layers, I didn't know that routers operate at layer 3, forwarding based on IP addresses, that's why they're called layer 3 routers. If I didn't know a layer 2 switch made forwarding decisions based on layer 2 MAC addresses, because it's a layer 2 switch, and I didn't have any of that knowledge, I would rate myself as a 1. And then I would start working in my first study session to help get that 1 to a 2. So the second step is to identify the topics and focus on them one at a time. Okay, the third problem and the third solution in our five-step process here is we need to avoid all theory, because there's two major success components. One is knowing the theory behind how something works, and the second is to actually know how to implement it. We have to know both. So we are going to need access to practice gear. There's no way around it. If you're going to be Cisco certified, Cisco wants you to know how to configure the gear, not just think about configuring the gear. If you ever saw the movie Music Man, where he taught the kids to think about how to play the instrument, it doesn't work. You have to actually get your hands on the gear. There's 3 primary options for that. 1 is having access to real gear. If you want real gear, you really need 3 routers and 2 switches. There's a ton of information on CCNA kits out there. There's a lot of variants and so forth. But you really need 3 low-end, fairly low-end routers and 2 switches to get the job done. And in the United States, you can get that today for around $300. It's a great investment. When I first bought my routers back in the 90s, late 90s, they were $5,000. I bought 3 routers used, and there were $5,000 for 3 routers, and that was without any extra interfaces. So I built my whole rack up, and it was worth it. It was worth it, and it's worth it today for $300 as well. The second option for real gear for routing purposes, for router practice, is GNS3. And there's lots of information on the internet about that. So it won't give you the switch practice. I get that. I know that. But it will give you great and most of your router practice. So GNS3 is a great option. And then the fourth one, or the third option, I should say, is the Academy. If you are a member or affiliated with Cisco's Network Academy, you can use Packet Tracer, which is a simulator, which is included as part of the Academy service that they offer. And it offers switch and router emulation, and you can simply run it on your Windows PC, and you're done. You can practice everything for CCNA right there. So that's our third step. Number one, schedule time. Two, identify the topics. Number three, make sure you have access to practice gear so you can practice. Okay, so the fourth step is to actually learn the content. Now, how do we learn the content? There are several different ways. One, you can go to Cisco's website and just read through the documentation, and it's great. I'm no kidding. Now, going to the source is great. However, for learning the technology and how it works, that usually isn't the only reliable source that you'd want to go to. So what you're going to need to get your hands on is some type of training, whether it's a class or self-paced training, something where you have an individual who really gets it, who can boil it all down, walk you through exactly how things function, demonstrate it, and then make sure you're good with that confirmation of how you understand that data. So in our network, for example, Nova Datacom is just finishing up our self-paced IC&D1 and IC&D2 course offerings, as well as Network Plus and Security Plus. And this is one of the topologies that we use. And by the time we're done, we start with this network from lesson number one. And by the time we're done with the entire course, not only do we understand the pieces and the parts and how they work, but a student would also have the experience from the self-paced training of how to actually configure it. So a student could get that self-paced training and go through the router section, for example, pause the video and say, okay, great, I want to practice myself, and then walk through it. So get some type of training from some vendor that works for you. I would strongly recommend that as our fourth element of success. And then finally, we need to make sure that in our study time, now that we've identified the topics, we have access to gear, you want to practice everything. Everything. Don't take anything for granted that you can test and verify, because that's going to help you really understand the technology. For example, implementing an IP addressing scheme or implementing a new routing protocol, you should be able to take a network and say, well, great, I want to go above and beyond what's just being talked about in the text. I want to actually implement my whole network with OSPF or EIGRP, and you should be able to actually implement it. Because that, my friend, is the secret of where you'll start really getting that deep down knowledge of how it operates. Here's what I've discovered, is that it doesn't always work like the book says. And there's only one way of really getting to know that technology, and that is to get busy practicing it. Also, I would strongly recommend, if you're on Cisco Learning Network, CLN, that you answer some questions for people. Take a look at them. Every time a question is posted, look at it. And think to yourself, do I know the answer to that? And if you do, or if you don't, either way, work through that answer, because that'll help build your own understanding as well. As you serve others, your own knowledge is going to increase. What I've learned as an instructor, and I've had the opportunity of doing instructing and consulting over the last 25 years, is that the instructor always has the opportunity to learn a lot more than the students do. As we prepare, we study, we think behind the scenes, and that's a great blessing, a benefit to both you answering somebody's question and the person who's getting that question answered. So those are our five major steps of success in passing a certification exam. Schedule time, identify the topics, get access to practice gear, then make sure that we get some training that works for you. And then five is to test everything. Practice it. If there's a topic, practice it. And then you'll know it and you'll own it. Not only will you be able to pass certification exams because you know the content, you'll also have great success as you move into the real world and apply those skills on the production networks, which employers will be more than happy to pay competent individuals to do. Thank you so much for listening, and have a great, great rest of the day.